Hey guys, Tablante here, and what I have in front of me is this awesome new monitor from ASUS. It's the PA32U. Pinahab nila sa akin to. So yeah, it's really spiffy. It's a professional grade monitor, so if you're a photographer who does this for a living, a videographer, gonna, this is the monitor for you. Amazing 32 inches, as you can see here. So guys, for this quick session, I'm gonna run through my workflow, basic clean ups, you know, how I chuck out model shoots on a regular basis. Here's one of the later shoots I did, and here's my model fish. And we're gonna open up the shot in Photoshop. If you want to geek out about it, the amazing part about this ProArt monitor is it has 100% faithfulness to sRGB and 99.5% faithfulness to Adobe RGB. So you can imagine the colors of those color spaces fully replicated. So, you know, and then that, basically, the colors are so rich. You guys could basically see the color gradations in the shot, from the highlights, to the shadows, to the mid-tones. It's just amazing looking at this monitor. And so much real estate, 32 freaking inches. I have not worked on a monitor this big. So the biggest monitor I've worked with is, you know, roughly about 27, which is also ASUS. Thank you guys for providing me that IPS monitor as well. I'll be editing my fashion work, glamour work, even some of the cosplay reviews of the cosplay shots here later on, or in a bit actually. Since this is a professional grade monitor, comes along with a package, its own color calibrator. Ta-da! So, of course, for the photography enthusiast or for the art director, graphics designer, if you're working with graphics a lot, it's always advisable to color calibrate your monitor, whether you're using it. ProArt monitor or for any monitor for that matter. Whenever I do model portfolio shots, I'm not exactly a big fan of post-production, so it's mostly cleanups here and there. And color grading, I'm a sucker for color grading. So when we open this up, I've already had the presets in Lightroom or Bridge, whichever you want to use. Open it up and here you go. Since the color grading has already been done in Bridge, there's nothing much to do. And I always like to keep my shots like these as raw as I can and as close to film as I can. So, you know, the presets that I made basically give a film-ish kind of feel to it. So it's all about experimenting with all those dials, that camera raw settings. And we're lucky enough that our model fish here has very good complexion. She has very good skin, so I hardly had to clean up anything on her face or on her body for that matter. As you can see, the colors are so different on the laptop versus the ProArt monitor. So if you're editing seriously, you can see how punchy the colors are on the big monitor versus the laptop and how much detail you can get out of this. All I'm doing now is just taking out some loose strands of hair on her cheeks, near her nose, and probably the forehead, and that's about it. Other than that, I already like the output of the shot. So yeah, let's move on to another picture. Oh, before I forget, this is an amazing 4K IPS monitor, so where can you go wrong with that? 4K resolution. So if you happen to plug this on a desktop with a very strong video card, like the ASUS Cerberus, I'm sure the graphics will really look awesome on this monitor. I would like to thank the guys from ASUS Philippines for lending me this wonderful monitor. Sana po di ko siya makuwi. But no, pinagaban naman sa akin ito for probably a week or two, so I'll have to return this to them after thoroughly reviewing it. More technical stuff, I guess, I will put on my blog. I'm not here to put some nitty-gritty numbers review. It's more like more of my experiences working with it. So as you can see, I love the colors as it is. And if you do this for a living, this monitor might be a worthy investment. For the heck of it, let's use some cosplay photos on this big monitor because it looks nice. There you go. Oh. The colors are very much, yeah.